a solution has to be found. Because of the very nature of the energy that was created as a mental energy, as an energy of individualized delusion, implied within that equal and one was a limitation to a single point, which made possible the manifestation of the individual form within the context of the triangle, because that emergence of an opinion, of a point of view about something in conflict with a point of view of another point created a triangle. Two points in conflict created a point of combustion, a point of friction, which created energy, another level of energy. That energy is the energy we today live as personality. That made it possible, obviously, for the automatic emergence of what you would call three dimensions, because that's how we created three dimensions as a system. The fact that that was a delusion didn't matter, because within that we became that separated opinion, that idea of ourselves. When we became that idea of ourselves, we created what you have today. Entities, beings, even in the physical, that exist not as the physical. You are existing as the mental projection of your physical self. So you became a digital self, a self contained within opinion, digits, symbols, which is not physical. Because remember, if you go back to the story of Anu and them, they took symbols from the planet. They took pieces of the planet and made symbols of it, which is they made an opinion, they created an idea. Then the idea became important, and your opinion about the idea became your mental projection, your delusion, your illusion, which you believe yourself to be, which you now would call a personality. This personality will fight for its existence by having a point of view, which is in conflict with another point of view. The friction between those two has created the system as it exists today. According to that, we have then made rules for the system, which is the laws and the moralities and the beliefs that exist today, which we then adhere to. We have taken that and put it back into symbols, which is writing, made it our laws, and we have bound ourselves to that. For that reason, something had to be created, a vacuum, which is Earth, the utmost fear. Where did fear ever existed from a perspective as we have it today before we created the mind? No, fear did not exist as that. Fear started existing as it exists today the moment we're starting to fear losing our point of view, which we believe to be ourselves, which was not really real. So you inevitably would lose that point of view because it isn't who you are. But the moment you believe that is all you are, you obviously, the moment the point of view no longer exists, you also no longer exist, which is how we created our own end, which we are now currently living out. We are now reaching the end of time, which means we are reaching the point where we can no longer generate this sustainable, this idea of ourselves sustainably, because we have created virtually in every possible way a form of conflict where we cannot trust each other, but we live in fear of each other. So we have become simply mental projections contained within the physical, which sucks the physical dry until it dies, and then the mental projection that remains is what you end up in the afterlife as, and that you are basically absolutely powerless. So unless you actually deliberately in the afterlife give up your existence within the understanding that you have become virtually an illusionary energy, you let it go, That means you give back what you have allowed you to become to its source, which is the physical. So that you become in that, the physical. You are pretty much screwed for eternity. Which is pretty cool from a certain perspective because you now have no impact whatsoever on the reality. You are simply non-existent. From the perspective now, imagine the problem that emerged from all of this, one's mental projection that you have become as personality has then created from its entities, which is the systems that come. These systems has become alive in a way because that, you know, you have changed its energy from the perspective of, or it is projections of energy. It is like a wave of, it's an outflow of, it's a mirror effect of the original energy. It's not the original energy. It is like having a picture taken of it and believing the picture to be real. It's how the mind system operates. Now imagine these things existed before Earth, existed a long time before it. Earth is just a manifestation where all of these points have been brought together so it can be seen to understand how we've created this reality, how we've created ourselves, in essence. So therefore, Earth had to be manifested as a singular point, which was everyone had to be brought together here to get stuck in the actual manifested illusion, which was sound, which is what Earth is. Earth is sound, and within sound, which contains all possible expressions, it's possible to actually manifest the illusion and live it as if it is real, so you can learn what is the consequence of your creation.